And finally, here it is, me streaming, Morrowind. Now, with Morrowind, it's a highly anticipated game for me to stream. After Oblivion, so I had this in the back of my mind when I was going to say it. A lot of people thought I was going to go do Skyrim, the next game, but I'm actually going back before Oblivion and doing Morrowind instead. No real reason, but I just kind of really just want to go back to Morrowind. Morrowind is, of course, a very different game than Oblivion. These streams will be a little bit more, I don't know how you want to say it, less funny in a way. Because Morrowind is more of a serious game than Oblivion. Oblivion is like, it feels more like a farcical cartoon at times, whereas Morrowind is a little bit more, I get a little bit more into Morrowind, you know? So, yeah, regardless, I'm really excited to do this. Morrowind is a fantastical game, and talked a lot about Morrowind during the Oblivion streams, so it's going to be exciting to do this. And maybe, who knows, maybe after this Morrowind playthrough, we'll go back and do Daggerfall, you know. Morrowind is humorous in its own way. Oh, absolutely. I'm not saying that what I'm trying to say here, Oblivion has ridiculous ragdolls and two voice actors. Morrowind, at times, feels like Todd Howard smoked a bunch of crack, and it's glorious. Like, it's fantastic. It's so fucking bananas at times. Now, what's going to be a little different about this Morrowind playthrough is that I'm going to be using just patches and a graphical extender. I will not be using any mods. Maybe later on we can start adding in a little haha stuff, but for now, completely vanilla, completely serious, no fucking stupid shit. Okay, maybe later. But for now, it's going to be solid Morrowind playthrough. Hey, I'm just kidding with you. I installed those, like, 4K nude mods for Morrowind. You thought I was going to take this seriously. No, I'm going to have floppy balls and titties and... Of course not. Wow. That was, like, one of my early experiences with mods when I discovered that, oh, people play Morrowind with their cocks out? Okay. Disturbing. And you know what's funny as fuck about that, here's a little story about this. Back in the year 2007-8, there used to be this like project called Beautiful Morrowind you can download, and it came pre-bundled with this nude mod, and nobody told me about it. So when I was installing it, I hit yes on everything, and one of the options you can install it is, do you want cock and balls? And I just said yes. So when I was playing it, I'm like, okay, I gotta remove these pants, I'm like, wow, what? No. Now, before we start this, I guess I just talk a little bit about my experience with Morrowind. You know, Morrowind was my first Elder Scrolls game back in 2004 or whatever. It was released 2002, but I really loved this game, but I could not get into it the way it was intended. I think a lot of people that played Morrowind back in the day kind of bullshitted their way through it and kind of like hit mud crabs and be like, wow, it's amazing. And I kind of did the same, and not until much later I got to really appreciate what the fuck this game is all about. This game is different from Oblivion, where there is really full control over what you want to do as a character. If you fuck up a vital NPC, they will remain dead. There's not a, it's not a big text screen saying no. Basically, there's a text screen saying, you fucked up, but that's okay. You can do whatever you want. In Oblivion, you can't do that. So, and the game is very unforgiving. It's got that, like, I don't know what you want to call it, brutal RPG-ness about it. Whereas in Oblivion, you can kind of bullshit your way through it. In this one, you gotta just keep your stats high, you gotta do what's right, and you gotta really... you suffer through the game if you want to play it right, I guess. But that's so rewarding in a way, too. I guess what I'm trying to explain here is this game is much more gritty in terms of gameplay in an Elder Scrolls sense. It uses more of a dice roll mechanic for the combat. There's a big meme about Morrowind, how you're missing all the time. And that's because people don't put the stats in for the right weapons, you know. This game also has different stats in Oblivion. You got light armor, medium armor, heavy armor. Tons of different stuff in this game. Of course, Oblivion has some better stuff than what Morrowind did, but I love Morrowind, and I hope I can reflect a little bit of that in my playthrough here tonight. Really cool game, really awesome, and this is not going to turn into a stream where I just praise Morrowind all the time and I shit on the other games. All the Elder Scrolls games are great for different reasons, And people always accuse the Elder Scrolls games of getting dumber and dumber each time they come up with a new one. Fun fact, when Morrowind came out in 2002, people dogged on this game and called it a stupefaction of Daggerfall. And when this came out, after a while, they said it was the best. And then Oblivion came out and was like, oh, this is stupid. And then everybody loved Oblivion. And then Skyrim came out and it was like, oh, it's a dumb Oblivion. So you don't need to listen to that. All the games are great for different reasons. They're fantastic. Tons of fun. And yeah, here's my little spiel about talking about that. But anyway, we're going to be playing Morrowind now. And I'm sorry that this took forever to do, you know, but it really is a testament to how much I care about this game. I really am not going into this blind. I took time and attention to set everything up right because this game really deserves it. I'm not going to be skimming through this game. I'm going to really sit down and do it. So